Hi friend, welcome to Plus2Net. Download the source code from the URL given at the description and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. We'll divide this in two parts. In part one, we'll understand how to display the present date and time by click of a button. Every time we click the button, the current date and time is displayed. In part 2, we'll not use the button but connect it to a timer function, so at every 1 second interval the current date and time is displayed or refreshed. So it will show the continuous clock or real-time clock in our screen. Now note that we are using client-side time to display and it is not the server time. We'll create a function display underscore city to display the date and time. In this function, there are mainly two lines. The first line reads the current date and time from client computer and store it in a variable x. Now in the second line, we assign the value x to one span element or div element which is having a id equal to ct. So whatever the value of x, it is displayed inside the element having the id value equal to ct. We'll create one button and on click event of this button we'll connect to this function. Now this function is our display underscore city, and whenever we click the button this function executes and displays the time inside the element that having the id ct. This is a standard HTML template. To this we'll add our code. So body on load will add the function, so when the page loaded our display city function gets executed for the first time. Now let us, after this we'll start our script tag, close the script tag here. Now let us start the function. Function name is display underscore city. We'll start function here. End it. First we'll declare the variable x is equal to new date. It's a date object it will store. Okay, now we'll go document get element by id. Now the id is ct for the clock we are used. Inner html is equal to x. The value of x is declared at the previous line. So now this much is our script. Now let us declare the span id equal to ct and let us close the span here. Now this is the clock. Okay, now in this clock we'll use input type is equal to button. Now value equal to, you can write your anything. I am writing show time. Okay, now what happened on click event is equal to the function name. I'll give it here display city, and mostly that should complete our code. So we have declared the button. This is the last line is the button part, then the span. You can use a div tag also. So and here is our function. Now body on load also this function will. So here is this part is the JavaScript part. We have kept it here. Okay, let us see. We'll refresh this page and see our time should display. Yes, time is coming. Now the time is not changing. We'll refresh this by clicking this button. Yes, you watch this part, it will be changing. So now it is changed. Every time I click the button, the value changes. It takes the fresh value, date and time value, and display it here. In part 2, we'll not execute any button click to trigger our display function. We'll use one timer function to execute our display city function at an interval of 1 second. Our timer function set time takes two inputs. One is the function it will execute and the other one is the time gap in milliseconds. Here we are using 1000 milliseconds or 1 second as the time interval. After this time interval, our timer will trigger our display function display city. We will use the function display c to keep the time function inside it. Now let us see how the we'll repeat the functions. Now we have two functions. One is display city to display the date and time. Another function is display underscore c, which will store the timer to trigger the display city function after a time gap of 1 second. To make this process repetitive, we will call display c function from display city function. By doing this, we will create one loop where both functions will execute each other, and calling of display city from display c is through timer set time with a delay of 1 second. Now each time the display city is executed, the function will display the current date and time, and the loop continues. Now we'll add the timer function here. So let us pop up this, use it. This is a function. Now display underscore c. Now the timer will be inside this. Okay, first we'll declare the variable refresh. It is equal to 1000 millisecond. Which if you want, we can increase it. Okay, let us say now the timer, my time equal to set timeout. Now the function name which we want to trigger, this is display CT, display clock. Now at a refresh we'll use here. So this is the refresh rate of 1000 millisecond or 1 second will be considered. Now at every 1 second this display city will be executed. Now from display city we'll also execute display C. So this play underscore C function should be called here. Now this should work for us. Now we can refresh this page and see that how the clock is changing. You can see now the clock is changing in real time. So displaying the actual date and time and data duration of it's a refresh rate of 1 second now.